friends, in this video I am going to discuss about the arrest of chartered accountant, woman chartered accountant at the age of 27. Is it a fair, why the real culprits have not been arrested? It is the time for the professional bodies to protect their professional interests in near future. Getting GST and other registration on behalf of clients is the normal activity for chartered accountant, advocates, tax consultants, accountants, company secretaries and other professionals. In all such cases, the tax professionals act as a mere facilitator to the client in getting the registration and not as agents of the clients. So they are mere facilitators, professionals, tax professionals, and not acting as agents of the clients. The ultimate registration is granted by the department after verification of the documents and records by GST office. If any of the taxpayers subsequently commits frauds or dupe the government, whether tax professionals can be arrested, whether the officer who has granted the registration, GST registration, is not the proper officer to be arrested in such a cases rather than the tax consultant. Is it right to prosecute the tax consultants who is just facilitating the process of registration in such cases? Whether tax consultants is expected to carry out the due diligence of the clients before accepting any routine work? Even in marriage proposals also, the due diligence may not be full proper. Can it be expected in professional client relationship? If the activity carried out by the taxpayer is illegal or not as per the permissible mode, whether tax consultants will be held responsible for this? This is the time to introspect, and professional bodies, ICAI, Bar Association, tax chambers need to take a call on this. It is not the question of one Paridhi Jain who has been arrested and put in a jail for a month, who was not only getting the firms registered at the biggest of her clients after collecting requisite documents from them. It is a livelihood, a chartered accountant of 27 years old. This lady is a livelihood, and is getting, when a client approaches her for registration, she has to do and charge fees for her livelihood. And she has, on the genuine proof, she is registering the client, and if the client later on deceives the department, she should not be held liable, or a tax professional should not be held liable. She was prosecuted for more than 1 month. It is a question of each and every tax consultant. If not now, then get ready for more instances like this. If it has come to Paridhi Jain today, it may come to you again in near future. It may come to you in the near future. So if it is Paridhi Jain today, it may be you tomorrow. The matter comes to light when the bail application is rightfully accepted by the Honorable Rajasthan High Court. In the case of Paridhi Jain versus State of SB Criminal Miscellaneous Bail Application Number 742-2020. The issue is not that she has been granted bail, but the main issue is to be observed is that she has been arrested and put in jail for more than a month. Why the question of bail has arisen for this 20 years young lady? Similar issues have happened in the past also. Why the matter been not taken up by the appropriate political and administrative forum of the Finance Ministry, CBIC, at least when the person is a member of the most respected fraternity and deserves respect and recognition? Was getting the registration certificate for the client is crime? Let the government comes with a model code of conduct for the model code of for the tax professionals, so that they can distinguish themselves from the clients who is likely to give false information. This is the time to revisit the routine activities and identify the areas and role the tax consultant should play. Taking actual ground level action is in such a case more important than planning CPE program. If not, who will be with Paridhi Jain? If you do not support Paridhi Jain today, nobody will support you if you have been in this, like this case, in the future. So join together and help Paridhi Jain. Not only help Paridhi Jain, you are going to help yourself. If not now, then when? It is she now, who will be the next? So questions to ponder. The main question in this case, why the tax authorities have arrested a tax consultant? Why the real culprits have not been arrested? The firm which has duped the government. Why the owner of the firm who committed the fraud have not been arrested? Why a chartered accountant has been made as a scapegoat, which prevented the tax officials from arresting the real culprits, that's owner of the firm. The tax professional act as a mere facilitator to the client in getting the registration, and she is not, or he is not, acting as the agents of the client. He is only a mere facilitator for registration of the document. If any of the taxpayers subsequently commits frauds or dupe the government, whether the tax professional can be arrested for that. Why they have not arrested the real culprits? That is the main $1 million question. Whether the officer who has granted the registration is not the proper officer to be arrested in such a case, rather than the tax consultant. The officer who has not scrutinized the documents which has been submitted is the real culprit, and he has to be taken on call, not the professional. Is it right to prosecute the tax consultant who is just facilitating the process of registrations in such a case? There, the tax consultant is expected to carry out the due diligence of the clients before accepting any routine work. This is the time to introspect, and professional bodies like ICAI, Bar Association, tax chambers need to take a call on this. These bodies should make immediate lobbying at the highest level of the government to safeguard the interest of the members and protect them in cases where they have been acted genuinely. Friends, I think you like this video. If you like it, please, I request you to subscribe my channel so that whenever I issue new topic, it will reach you directly. Thanking you once again, R.V. Shekhar, practicing company secretary.